Hello and welcome back to the video Darkroom. I've noticed that there isn't an abundance of options for displaying a stopwatch in Premiere, and in particular there are very few that allow you to have hundredths of a second displayed on it. Not only that, but most of the ones that are there as a technique work on the basis of the frame rate, which really means counting up to 25 frames per second or 30 frames per second or 60 frames per second and then flipping over to the next second, which is not really the way a stopwatch works. So I have produced an option in After Effects that you can use as a motion graphics template, a MOGRT in Premiere, and it's got flexibility. You can start it, you can stop it, you can display the hours if you want, you can display the minutes if you want, and you can change the colors of the text and the background and customize it as you need it for your video. So let's get into After Effects and I'll show you how you can create that and then export it as a MOGRT or a motion graphics template into Premiere. Let's start in After Effects. We're in After Effects with a new project and the first thing to do is to create a new composition. This brings up a dialog box where we can give the composition a name. I'll just call it Stopwatch. And then we have some parameters to fill in. I've already tested this out, so they're already set, but just to go through them, I've set the width to 500 pixels. There's absolutely no need to create a full screen composition for this one. So I've set the width to 500 pixels and the height to 200 pixels, which should be big enough for any stopwatch that we might want to use as a motion graphic in Premiere or in After Effects for that matter. And I have then critically set the frame rate to 100 frames per second. The reason being, I do want to use the time code to run the stopwatch. And so we need hundredths of a second, so a frame rate of 100 frames per second will give us that. And then start time code should be zero. Now for the duration, you can set this to whatever length you will want that stopwatch to run for. So if you want it to run for an hour, then you should set the duration to 1 hour, no minutes and no seconds. If you want it to run shorter than that, then just enter whatever time you need. In this case, I'm creating a stopwatch that will run potentially for 10 minutes if you want it to. You'll be able to run it for less than that, but that's the maximum time that this will run for once you've set the length of the composition to be 10 minutes. So we'll say okay on that one, and we now have our composition. Before we can add the time code to this, we need to have something to add it to. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to the layer menu, type in new and adjustment layer, and that will create an adjustment layer the same size as the composition. And it can be handy just for the purposes of getting everything aligned properly if we go to the view menu and show rulers. I can then drag a guide down on to show where the center is going to be, and I can drag a horizontal guide there onto it as well. And we're now in a position to add the effect to this, which is the time code. I'm going to just go up to effect, go down to text and add time code, and time code now appears on the screen. We can open this up by opening up the layer, then opening up effects, opening up time code, and I'm going to set the text size to be 80, and that's going to give a time code about the size that we wanted here. We'll be able to increase it or reduce it once we get into Premiere. And now you can see why I put the guides on here. So I'm just going to use those guides to set up the time code centrally. So that looks like it's pretty much in the middle. We can go back to the view menu and we can clear the guides, and they're gone because we don't need them anymore. So if I just let the video play, I'll just select the timeline, press space, and you can see that as the playhead moves from left to right, we're running through 5, 6, 7 seconds and the hundredths are being displayed. Press space again to stop it. We've one more change to make here before we create the MOGRT, and that is to move the anchor point of the adjustment layer. You can see I've just selected transform, and that's transform for the adjustment layer, not transform for the effects, which I could close down effects, and you can see just the parameters that are available for adjusting the adjustment layer. I'm picking anchor point, and I'm going to move it over to the right hand side. And the reason that I'm going to do that is so that when we crop this or scale the adjustment layer, we'll be able to eliminate the hours or the minutes from this and leave just the seconds and the hundredths or whatever portion of the stopwatch we want to remain displayed on the screen. If I left this in the middle, when we scaled it, it would be cropped in from both sides. But if I move it over to the right hand side, the scaling effect will be to scale it down from the left hand side, which is the way we want to conceal the parts of the stopwatch that we don't want to be seen. To do that, we use the anchor point tool, click on that, and then position it over the anchor point, move that across to the right. I'm actually holding down shift to make sure that it moves exactly in the middle, and I just want to move it outside the right hand side of the last digit. That's everything that we want to do, and the effect, the stopwatch, is now ready for being converted into a motion graphics template. To do that, I'm going to go to composition and open in essential graphics, and now the composition is opened here in this panel, which is the essential graphics panel. We can give it a name, and this is the name that it will have when it comes across into Premiere through the library. So I'll select all of that and just call it stopwatch. And then if I click on solo supported properties, the properties that we can use, that we can transfer as being ones that can be reset in Premiere, will appear within the timeline panel. And we can drag any of these up into the essential graphics panel. That means they'll come across as being parameters that we can adjust in Premiere. So the ones that we want to move are, first of all, we'll take the text color and drag that up. And that is now something that can be altered in Premiere. I'm going to take the show box and bring that up. And currently the box is set to black, so you're not really seeing it here. If we were to change that box to, say, to red, you'll see where the box is, and changing the box, show box on or off, either displays it or leaves it out. So let me just move that back to black. If I just take the brightness and drag that all the way down to the bottom, that will get it back to black. So I'm going to put the box color up here as well. So now we can show a box and we can make that background box any color that we want to. I'm going to also take opacity and set it up here. It wouldn't often be used, but it may just be that you don't want the stopwatch to appear at 100% opacity. There would be ways to manage that within Premiere, but we'll put it up here as a parameter that can be used anyway. And finally then, I want to take up the scale parameter, and this is the one that will actually be used to crop the stopwatch, because the scale is going to affect the scale of the adjustment layer, not the scale of the stopwatch. You'll see how it works once we get into Premiere, but it will basically allow us to crop in from the left-hand side and crop out the hours or the minutes as we need to. In order to do that, we don't want to crop equally top and bottom, left and right, so I'm going to click on the little lock icon that locks the scale horizontally and vertically, and then I'm going to drag the scale up here, and that means we can change each of these independently. That's everything that we need to do now in Essential Graphics, and I'm going to export the motion graphics template. After Effects always asks you to save the project. In this case, this project has never been saved before, So I'll just save it as stopwatch. And now we get the opportunity to choose where we're going to put this. In this case, I have a demo library. We're going to put it in there. And you can add keywords to this if you think you have a lot of motion graphics templates, a lot of MOGRTs, and you want to use keywords to find the ones that you want. In this case, we'll just leave that out and say OK. And that's done. This motion graphics template is now in your library and ready to be used. So let's go into Premiere and I'll show you just how you can use this in a Premiere sequence. We're in Premiere and I have a project here which we can use for demo purposes. I'll play it through and you'll see how it works. It builds up a little track where we're going to animate some runners across it. There is a voice that says 3, 2, 1, go. And at that point, a stopwatch starts and times the runners as they move across the screen. So let's just have a quick look at that.
Let's get this restarted. 3, 2, 1, go!
So you can see that as we move through this timeline, a stopwatch appears. And then at the point at which go is said by the voiceover, then the stopwatch starts counting up. Seconds and hundredths of a second. To show how this stopwatch is used, let's open up this nested sequence here. I just double clicked it to open it up. And this is where the stopwatch is put on and all the various track elements are built up. We don't need to concern ourselves with these, but you can see as you go through this, the track elements build up, the stopwatch is added. At this point, this is the track that has the stopwatch. And as we go through that point, the stopwatch starts and starts counting up as it goes through and the various characters animate at the same time, but we don't need to concern ourselves with them. It's only the stopwatch. So in order to show you how this stopwatch was applied to this, I'm going to delete the current one out from it. So I've deleted that out. We've now got no stopwatch. So just let's see how the motion graphics template that we created in After Effects can be applied to this particular sequence. We go to Essential Graphics and we go to Browse, and here is the stopwatch. We're in the demo library that I exported this to, and so we have the stopwatch here as a motion graphics template. This is the very one that we just exported from After Effects. So I'm just going to drag that onto the sequence. And I have already set a marker on this sequence. That's the point at which the voiceover says go. So that's the point at which we want the stopwatch to start. If I play from there, you can see that it starts exactly at that point. So there's a few things that we need to do to it. So I just first of all select that stopwatch effect. And I'm going to go in here and just change the scale of it and bring it down to something which is more like what we want. Stopwatch should look, I think, something like that. That seems to be about right. If I click on motion within the effect controls, I can just pick that up and drag it to where we want it to be, which is something like there. Now, it's a little bit big. So I'm going to just take that scale down a little bit further. So I'll just drag that to the left and take it down a little bit further. Let's assume that that's okay now. You remember that we put in the option to include the box behind it. In this case, I would quite like to switch that off because it's interfering with the arrow there. So I can switch off the background to the stopwatch and now we only have the figures blending in nicely with the underlying clip that is there. I could, for example, change the color of the stopwatch by clicking here and selecting this and picking the yellow color that's there, saying OK. And we now have something that matches in with the other text that's on the screen. And finally, we don't want hours on this. We just want minutes, seconds, and hundredths on it. So this is where we use the scale parameter. So I'm just going to click on the scale, drag slightly to the left to reduce the scale. Remember, it's the scale of the adjustment layer, not the scale of the effect. So I can just bring it in till we're just excluding the hours out of this. And we now have a stopwatch that shows minutes, seconds, and hundredths, which is exactly the way that we want it to be. Now, this is all very well. The stopwatch starts at the right time and counts up. But we would really like this stopwatch to appear on the screen set to all zeros before it actually starts up. The way to do that is to go to the point at which it does display all zeros, which is here, and we want to add in a frame hold segment. Now, it's important if you add in a frame hold segment that you disable the synchronization or disable the sync lock on all of these other tracks. I've set them all off. I was just setting off the last one. And the reason for that is if we insert something here, it would split these other clips that are on the other tracks. So I've just disabled the sync lock on all of those, at least just temporarily. I can now right click on the stopwatch and I can add a frame hold segment, and it's added that segment in. So I'm going to push that segment back to the point where we want the stopwatch to start, and I'm going to bring the stopwatch back to there. And now as I scrub through the timeline, you can see that the stopwatch is zeros and then it starts counting at that point. Inserting the frame hold segment has also moved our little marker, which is a useful marker to show where the stopwatch is supposed to start. So I'm just going to move it back to where it was, and I'm going to drag back the frame hold part of this right back to here. And now you can see that as the track is built up, there is that stopwatch that's all zeros, and we reach here and it starts to count. Now, supposing we wanted to stop the stopwatch at some point in time, then what we can do is we can choose the point at which we want it to stop. We can cut the clip that has the stopwatch. So I'll just type Control K and cut that clip and delete the running stopwatch from the end of it. I'm going to go back one frame to get the stopwatch to appear again, and that's the point at which it's going to stop. I can right click on that and add frame hold, and it's now added one frame that we can use to extend that out. So now what happens is the stopwatch is at all zeros, the stopwatch starts to count, showing the hundreds, and then it stops at that point. So you can choose wherever you want to stop the stopwatch. Let's go back to the track demo. I'm just going to press the backspace and play this to show how it works now.
Let's get this restarted. 3, 2, 1, go!
So you can see there that the stopwatch started with all zeros. It counted up when we needed to, and artificially I stopped it at this point of 1 second and 84 hundredths of a second. So that shows you how you can use the motion graphics template, or the MOGRT that you created in After Effects, and how you can apply it to any project that you want. You can have it whatever color you want. You can have the background whatever color you want. If I just went into this and we look at the stopwatch, I could go back into Essential Graphics. Then we could change the background color. First of all, show the box, change the background color, and let's just change it to red. Say okay on that, and you now have a background of red. You could trim it in. You remember that we have this trim capability vertically and horizontally. If you didn't want that box to be quite so big, you could trim it in. And that's why it was important to center the effect on the adjustment layer, so that it'll trim in equally top and bottom, and it will also trim in from the left to trim out the hours and minutes if you need that. So I hope you find that creation of that motion graphics template for a stopwatch useful, and you can apply it in any project any way that you want. And if you did find it useful, please give the video a like, and it would really help if you subscribe to the channel as well. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.